Hello everyone, my name is Rune, and welcome to a brand new series here on my channel, where we're going to play through Fallout 3, but with a little bit of a catch. We're only going to actually use the BB gun as a weapon. It is the only gun that this game ever requires you to fire at any point at all. You can actually go through most of the game without firing a weapon if you wanted to. I think it's actually only really required like once or twice to kill something. And even then, you probably aren't the one that has to kill the thing. You just have to be there when it dies. And I thought this would be kind of fun because the BB gun is like literally the worst weapon the game could offer you. And they offer it to you at the very beginning of the actual game. So I thought that would be kind of fun, you know? Now, before we actually get into it, I'm going to let you guys know that I'll be playing it on hard difficulty. I could go over to very hard, but for now, I think hard is going to be difficult enough as it is. If you guys really want, I'll switch over to very hard. I don't really care. I'll leave that up to you guys. So let me know. Do you guys want me to just go over to very hard, or is hard just okay? I don't know. I'll leave it up to you guys. Let's get into this and begin our journey into Fallout 3. Boy or a girl? So we are a girl for this run. I'll explain why in a little bit.
A girl? A girl? We've got a daughter, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby girl.
Oh, James. We did it. Oh, a daughter. Oh, our beautiful daughter.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, sweetie. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, sweetheart. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
And for my name, my parents were very smart and figured out what I was destined to do with my life. From the very beginning, by naming me BB gun, name, don't you think? Or Baby gun, depends on how you pronounce it. All right, so we're gonna be Caucasian. This doesn't really matter. I'm gonna basically set the character up like I normally set up all of my characters. Hairstyle. You don't really have to do much in this game. I don't know why her hair looks so weird blonde, but I'm gonna make it pitch black because that's how I like my female characters to look in this game. Bam, perfect and done. That is literally it. The next big step is our special, which we really can't fuck up because it'll be very critical to how we play through this thing. Okay, so for my build here, I'm gonna actually try. Okay, so I actually kind of fucked this up. And we're actually gonna keep it how it is now, and then we'll fix it once we actually get to the end of the vault. Actually, the game's not gonna let me, so I'm gonna put stuff where I think it needs to go for now. And we will fix it later. It doesn't actually matter right now. There's nothing in the vault section of this that's actually going to really affect it. Luck might have a little bit of a play on how well we kill the rad roaches that we'll end up fighting later, but that's about it. All right, so now we're 10 years old. Woo, pit boy time. Yeah, I actually really like the opening to this game. There's a lot of little, it's a really clever way to teach you how to play this Fallout, because it was the first 3D entry into the Fallout franchise, having been a top-down RTS, or turn-based strategy. Was it a turn-based or real-time? It was turn-based, I guess. Yeah, this was a really clever way to, you know, teach you how to play a 3D Fallout game that didn't require you to, you know, strategize everything ahead of time. It was kind of cool, but there are some problems that I'll talk about in a little bit. There's a video that actually kind of explains it pretty well. It's basically like, Well, like, for some reason, everyone is just super violent towards you once you try to get out of the vault. Like, they will shoot you and any other person trying to escape on sight, which is stupid. Why would you do that? Focused on the rad roaches, not on killing your own people. You, great party, Yamada. Yeah, thanks. I really have no idea. Yeah. Thanks for the Grognak the Barbarian. Can I read that now? Damn. Melee weapons increased by one. Cool, that'll never come in handy. Okay, so I'll talk about this little section here really quick. So there's actually something kind of clever about the BB gun that we're about to fire. It is actually the only unique variant of the BB gun in this game. The only thing that makes it unique is that it has 100% durability. The durability, it can't actually lose its durability, and technically it qualifies as a gun that has infinite ammo because your dad will give you ammo the second it runs out. It's ridiculous. There aren't any other variants of the BB gun in this game, and there weren't any unique variants of the BB gun until New Vegas came out. And it still wasn't really unique in any way. I'm kind of surprised. I got a BB gun. Whoa! I get to shoot a gun. It is literally the same gun. I forgot to change my FOV. Sorry. It's literally the same BB gun as you're about to get, but the durability is 100%, and you can't run out of ammo. Okay, so shoot these, which will trigger the rad roach to pop out suddenly. Yeah, so even rad roaches are kind of a bitch to kill in this. So we're gonna be using vets quite a bit. I didn't realize you actually got XP from killing that. That's funny.
Let's get a picture together. Hey, Jonas. Get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Yeah. Fuck you, Jonas. Hey, shoot at the targets, okay? How about I shoot at you, Jonas?
Smile.
Okay. And now this. The goat. This will have a big effect on how we play things in a little bit as well. You hurry up.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old girl. So, yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got to...
Bye, Dad. Bye-bye. I'm going to grab the bobblehead here really quick as well. Medicine is going to be pretty handy later on.
Good. To see the old man.
Hey, look.
Bottle snakes, you guys are... You guys are some kind of gang. I don't want to piss him off. What's going on here?
None of your business, kid. Get out of here. If you mess with the tunnel snakes, you're asking for it. Got me?
No. If you keep messing with her, the overseers are going to come down on your gang.
Like I'm going to listen to a little shrimp like you. Get lost, Poindexter.
Wow, we actually failed that. Leave her alone, or you'll answer to me.
And who are you? Her girlfriend? Ha! Should have known.
Wow.
Keep talking like that, girl, and we'll send you back to your daddy with a few...
See, I can't fight him, because that'll literally invalidate the run. I'm just gonna be going now.
Damn right.
Get out of... Stupid tunnel snake.
What? Yep.
Can you talk to them?
Look, Amada, this is none of my business. I don't want to get involved.
Don't want to get involved? Thanks a lot.
I'm sorry.
Go. I don't need your help any.
I'm sorry. I can't invalidate the run at the very beginning. Yeah. All right, sure, let's get ready. I don't care what these guys are saying. I know you guys probably don't either, so we're just going to get into the goat. Fortunately, we got to wait for all the NPCs to sit down, which could take a good second. I'm sorry, Amada. I really would have helped out, but I can't invalidate. If I get in a fist fight with him and lose, he just kind of becomes a cocky asshole.
Well, now that
which will be nice later. I don't know why he's like, oh, don't keep your eyes on your own paper. It's not really a test. It's kind of like a questionnaire. I actually wonder what the paper they're looking at says. Is it like a... Let's look. Oh, no. Okay, they all got up. Never mind. All right. Hey. But Mr. Brotch. It says here you're perfectly suited for a career as a... Waste management? That can't be right. Stupid test is all wrong. If you don't... Okay, so yeah, this is complete... Actually, small guns is right. Unarmed is not right. We're going to put it in sneak, and... We can either do repair or science right now, but I think repair is going to be a little more handy right away. All right, so that's that. See you tomorrow, bright and early. And now we get into the real game.
Come on, wake up.
Hi, Amada. Sorry for being a dick like 3 years ago.
You've got to wake up.
I was wrong.
You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you.
Oh, they didn't come to look for me in my own room. What do you mean my dad is gone?
He's left the vault. I don't know how, but he's gone. And my father, he's kind of gone crazy.
I've never seen you so scared.
It's Jonas. They killed him. My father's men. They took him and... Oh my god, you have to leave now.
Yeah, their whole mentality is ridiculous. Why would they...
Yeah.
Why would they kill Jonas?
I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute.
But I can't have left.
Not anymore, apparently. But are you honestly telling me you had no idea your dad was leaving? He really didn't tell you?
No, I had no idea he was planning to leave.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan.
Escape the vault? How?
Listen. There's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in.
Sounds like a good plan. Let's get out of here.
One more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case.
Thanks, Amada. I'll only use it in the last resort, I promise.
Okay. I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck.
Thanks, Amada. All right, so here is the BB gun that we'll be using throughout this entire run. I'm actually going to take the baseball bat because I can sell that later. We can also take these jumpsuits because, you know, selling stuff is good. We want to get money. And we also have some medical stuff that we'll be using for sure. I think that's it in terms of all that. Again, we're not going to be using any of these. BB gun only, which has a damage of 2. It's a lovely little gun. Now, Gomez just chilling here. Hey, Gomez. Bye, Gomez. Not going to really talk to you. We're not friends. Oh, that's the wrong door. Okay, my bad. Yeah, you have fun with those. I'm not going to help. Or, you know, get involved. Hey, Butch.
You got to help me. My mom's trapped in there with the rat roaches.
See, you're kind of a dick, Butch. Butch, asking me for help? If only you knew what irony... If only you knew what irony was.
Yeah, I'm asking you. So what? Look, I'm sorry for the way I've always treated you. You know I never meant any of it, right? But it's my mom. You can't leave her in there with the rad roaches.
Alright, I'll help.
Sure, I don't care why. Just get her out of there.
Yeah, so it probably isn't the best idea to be wasting ammo on, like, 3 rad roaches. But I can, again, use his, I can actually use his, what he gives us to gain some more money, which we're gonna want. Money is good in this game, because we're gonna need a lot of money for ammunition, because you can't really find, BBs too often in the wasteland. Alright, bam, all dead. How you doing? Ellen, oh, Ellen? What? Okay.
I did it! My mom's gonna be okay! You're the best friend I've ever had, man! Hey, I know it isn't much, but I want you to have my Tunnel Snake's jacket. Go ahead, take it.
Thanks, Butch. You're so nice. Alright, well, he gave us that. Doesn't really matter, because it only gives us an increase to melee, which we're not gonna be doing. Sadly, here's Grandma Taylor. Rest in peace, Grandma Taylor. You were really nice. I liked you a lot, but unfortunately you had to die to rad roaches. I am going the wrong way, and these rad roaches are coming at me. Alright, we're going to head up here. We're basically going to try and avoid as much combat as humanly possible. Not going to worry about these guys. They got it. They're helping me. Unlock this. Can we unlock it? Thank you. Ooh, hey, Stanley.
Me and Andy were in a tight spot there. Ain't no mistake. Good thing he loves toasting roaches so much.
Medical data system? I can't get in there. Okay, is there anything in here? I haven't really looked around this section of the game before, so just making sure that I'm not going to miss out on anything, you know, really handy. Alright, well, that's about that. We're going to head the hell out. I'm going to save these two from death by poking one of these guys with my BB gun. Yeah, they run away. No need to worry about them. They run away. And rad roaches. Okay, we're at 38 BBs left. That shouldn't be a big problem. We're going to try... The first thing we're going to do once we get out of here is get some more ammunition for this thing. Because I really can't risk not having ammo. Alright, so we're going to take all that stuff off him. Anything good in here? That is worth a bit. Ow, hello, ow, don't touch me. Alright, so... gonna open this. And then get Amada to run out. Oh, okay, smacking me up a bit. No need to kill these guys. They don't need to die today. I'm gonna just get the hell out. Hey, Jonas, I liked you a lot. We'll take all your stuff. Unfortunately, I'm gonna strip you naked. Sorry, Jonas, I really am. Nothing personal, it's just I need to have money. Alright, more stuff. Alright, and then we're gonna quickly get... Ow, stop poking me. Thank you very much. Open Overseer's Tunnel. Alright, I just gotta avoid taking hits for a minute. Normally I kill these guys, but you know, they're, you know, I kind of can't, or I don't want to waste ammo on people that don't really need to die. They basically vanish after we get out of here, so it's not like it really matters anyway. I think they're focused on the rad roaches now anyway, so no big deal. They're not gonna follow me out here. And then that is it. We are now quickly out of the vault, nice and easy. Just gotta stay near the entrance because they will pop out of there. Hey, Amada.
You did it! You opened the door! My god, I almost didn't believe it was possible.
I couldn't have done it without your help.
No, you didn't need me.
I did.
If anyone can survive out there, it's you.
Why don't you come with me?
It's tempting, but my place is here. The vault needs me more than you do. I'm the only one who has a chance to talk some sense into my father. Listen. If you do catch up with your dad, tell him I'm sorry for you know, Jonas and my father and everything. Goodbye.
Oh, alright, goodbye. It was nice seeing you. I liked you a lot, Amada. It's too bad you kind of become an asshole. I don't know. Normally these guys don't... Come on, stop touching me. Come on, open. Thank you. Okay. Actually, really quick before we leave. This is a nice little touch. There are picket signs. Let us in, motherfuckers. Help us. We're dying assholes. It's kind of clever. It kind of showed off, like, people were not too happy that they couldn't get into the vaults. Alright, so before we leave, of course, I need to change up my special. Agility. So, I kind of fucked up on my system here that I was going to be doing. High charisma will improve people's disposition towards you. See, I want to have a decent charisma. Strength, we might need to... Yeah, strength is actually, believe it or not, one we don't have to worry about too much. Luck we need to have really high. So 8 is probably good. Agility affects your small guns and sneak. Definitely need that. Against bonus to explosive, lockpick, and energy weapon skills. And determines... I don't think we're going to need to worry about strength too much. Normally, endurance is a measure of your overall physical fitness, health, environmental resistance, and actually, we don't really need endurance, funny enough. I'll put strength back up to 5. Luck, agility, I might... A good high intelligence would be kind of handy, but I think we're... I'll put it up to 8. Charisma we can increase later, I think. Yeah, I think that's overall going to be okay. I think that's a pretty decent build. But 2, 5, 8, 7, 8. I think we'll be okay. I think that's going to work for what I need to do. And with that, we're going to exit Vault 101 and head into the Wasteland. Good to be back. So, big thing we need to do is we need to get our sneak up to at least... I'm going to put it up to 50 for at the very beginning, believe it or not. And then I'm going to put science up to 25. The reason I want my sneak to be as high as possible at a very early stage is because we're going to be relying on it a lot. We're not going to be... We're basically going to try to avoid getting in combat as much as humanly possible. Because the BB gun is terrible. It's an awful weapon that nobody likes using because it's bad. Next, we'll deal with speech and barter. Basically, we're going to get... as we go, I'll kind of talk about it. And Black Widow is actually what we're going to start off with because I think... statistically, you're more likely to run into male characters than you are female characters in terms of, like, raiders and black... what are those guys called? I can't remember their names. Just mercenaries and all those guys in general, you're just going to more than likely run into males more than females. So that 10% extra damage is pretty dope at the very beginning. We're going to head over to Megaton really quick before we actually go off to get some ammunition, because we can make a quick buck thanks to Megaton. And we'll figure out, I'll tell you why once we actually are in there. Fun fact about this guy sitting up here, Stockholm, you can actually, if you cheat to get up there, he'll actually, there's a unique bit of dialogue that you can have with him. I showed off, but again, I'm not trying to cheat. I'm not trying to, you know, invalidate the run in any way. We're gonna play this as legit as possible. I don't even have real mods installed, funny enough. Well, hi, Lucas Sims. It's good to see you again, buddy. Nice hat. I don't really care. Message received. Looking for my father. I have to go now. I don't really care.
Got my eye.
Yep. Okay, gotta go. Thank you. I'm gonna quickly be really... I think you need a repair of 25 to disarm the bomb permanently, because that's definitely what we're going to be doing. No, explosives of 25. Okay, well, my bad. I'll come back and deal with this later, actually. So, big thing that we're going to do is we're going to head over to... Moriarty's Saloon, because we can make a quick bit of caps through this guy. We can make about 300, but in reality we'll make 200 off of this, and you'll see why in a second. He has a little quest in case you can't afford to get him caps. He asks for, I think, 100 caps for information on your dad, but I don't think we really have 100 caps. We have no caps whatsoever, so... yeah, I don't think I'm going to get in trouble for opening that door. I'm going to lose a bit of karma. That's about it. Not a big deal. Moriarty, where are you, buddy? Where is Moriarty? That guy. Fuck you. We'll deal with you later. Where is Moriarty? He's usually just hanging out in here. Moriarty? What? Where is he?
You really are.
Huh. Colin said... there he is. Hey.
Colin Moriarty, at your service. Welcome to Moriarty's. If you've got the caps, I've got your...
okay, money. Yeah. I'm looking for my father, middle-aged guy. Maybe you've seen him?
My God, it's you. The little baby girl, all grown up. Persistent little flower, ain't you? Then and now, it would seem. It's been a long time, kid. Oh, your daddy passed through here, all right. Here and gone. Got what he came for and then left. I'm assuming you'll do the same, correct?
You're lying. The vault's been sealed for 200 years.
God in heaven, would you listen to yourself? Do you honestly believe that's true? The lies they've put into that head of yours. Your father brought you to the vault right after you were born. To keep you safe, you see. I remember it well. You stayed in my saloon, after all. That's right. Your father, his brotherhood of steel friend, and you, the suckling babe with nary a tit to suckle. Sorry about your mum. Truly. But no matter. That big round door is open now, hasn't it? Daddy's gone, and you need to know why. Could be I know where and why.
Dad, you're wrong. You're a liar, Marty. I know where I grew up.
Ah, I see. You know, I heard about the brainwashing that goes on down there from some other fella escaped, 5 years back. All hail the overseer. We're born in the vault, we die in the vault, and all that other assorted lunacy. Kid, you've got better programming than our own Deputy Weld. You best wise up quick. Wouldn't want anyone taking advantage of you,
I was kidding. Dad talked about you all the look, I just want to find my dad.
You seem like a nice kid, so I'm going to be straight with you. Your dad was here, and now he's not. And yes, I know where he went. But what you're asking me for is information, and information is a commodity. Let's say 100 cops, and Daddy's location is yours. Very reasonable.
I don't have 100 caps. 100 caps? Are you nuts? I don't have that kind of money.
Guilty as charged. Tell you what, kid. I'm going to help you out, for old time's sake. If you don't have the caps to pay for the information, then maybe you could do a little favor for me.
Sure. Anything for information.
Eager, eh? Good. I like that. It's nice to have a doer in this shithole of a town for a change. This junky bitch named Silver borrowed quite a few caps from me. Claimed she could start funneling Jet and Psycho to me for a good price. Problem is, she scrammed with the loot and set herself up in Springvale so she can inject herself into a stupor. Get the caps she owes me, and they're yours. Yours to pay me with, anyway.
All right. Well, that's what we're going to go do. We're going to go deal with Silver. The reason we're going to go deal with Silver is because she will be... She really doesn't like Moriarty, and she will pay up. But instead of paying up the 100 caps, she'll give us a nice, good chunk of cash to use. And once we get back, we'll go to Crater Site Supplies to, you know, sell the stuff that we kind of took from the vault. Hey.
Who the hell are you? Where'd you come from? Did Moriarty send you?
Chatter the caps, I'll be on my way.
Owe him some caps? He's a liar! He just wants you to kill me. Those caps are mine, fair and square.
Slow down. Okay. This is a risky... Okay. Just give me the caps and I'll tell him you're gone.
Look, I don't know who you crap. Are. I'm not just handing over my life's earnings to you.
Just give me some of your caps and I'll tell him you're gone.
You do that for me? I never expected anyone to care enough. Here you go. Thanks, kid.
I really don't care.
You're right.
You're just a really, really easy source of caps. All right, so now we're going to quickly just head back over to Megaton. And then we're going to head right over to Crater Site Supplies because I need to sell the crap in my inventory for an extra bit of caps. And maybe we can get some new armor as well along the way because this vault suit is not the greatest in terms of quality and damage resistance. By the way, Moira is by far one of my favorite characters in this entire game. She's got so much personality to her.
You're that stray from the vault. Oh, I haven't seen one of you for years.
Ah, Moira.
Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Crater Side Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say, I'm working on a book about the Wasteland. It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you?
Now, normally I would help you right now, but, no, I don't want anything to do, sure, I got plenty to say about
great.
Life in the vault.
Just tell me what it's like to live underground all your life, or to come outside for the first time, or whatever strikes your fancy.
It was paradise down there. No fears, no worries, fighting until Dad left.
A runaway dad, huh? I've seen plenty of them before, but none with the big 101 on their back. Good luck finding him. Maybe the armored vault suit will help you out there, huh? That'll be good for the book. In fact, want to help me with the research? I can pay you, and it'll be fun.
We are actually going to help her for the most part. There is a couple of missions that require us to use a different weapon. And I think there's a way to bluff our way through it and, you know, actually manage to if you guys, there's a mission that she requires you to do where she wants you to try out this mole rat repellent, which is a melee weapon that basically makes them their heads explode. And I think there's a way to make it so that you can lie to her and get your bluff your way through it, but I won't know until we try. So, Book, what are you working on?
Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a Wasteland survival guide. For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens.
Nope.
No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean, mean words.
Sounds like a great idea. Can't wait to help.
Good enthusiasm. Now, I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers. Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food, the dangers of radiation, and how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines. Ooh, sounds like fun, doesn't it?
Yep.
Which do you want to do first?
We're actually going to do the landmine one first, believe it or not.
Landmines are one of the few dangers out there that you can profit from. Disarm one before it blows, and you can sell it for plenty of caps. I've heard stories about a ghost town that's just full of mines. Traders just call the place Minefield. Sounds like the place for some field work. Get in there, get back, and tell me all about it. And could you bring back a mine for my studies?
Yeah, sure. Not a minefield. Wish me luck.
Oh, don't worry. No one ever goes there because they say it's a ghost town. And since ghosts don't exist, you can just focus on the landmines. I hear there's a playground in the middle of town. Reach that point and come back, and I'm sure you'll have some stories to tell.
Yep. All right, but before we go...
What do you need?
Let's see what you have to sell. But in reality, we're going to sell a bunch of stuff to you. All our ammo is going towards you. Oh, did she give us the armored jumpsuit? Oh, cool. Okay. What does that actually do? Oh, small guns plus 5. It's really good, actually. She doesn't have a lot of caps on her, fortunately. Hold on, let's see something. Damage resistance is 12 on that. Oh, she only has one thing of leather armor today. That's interesting. Usually she has a bit more. She has a lot of radiation suits for some reason. That's really weird. Anything else I can use? I could probably use a couple of stimpaks. Or. Yeah. You don't sell BBs, unfortunately. Okay. That's about it, I think.
Good hunting.
Yep. Actually, before we go, can you repair my BB gun? Only a little bit. Okay, cool. Thanks, Moira. I'm gonna head out now. Now, before we actually head towards Minefield, we actually do need to make a quick stop somewhere else. I didn't actually know she gave us this armor right away. I thought this was something she gave us at the end of the first set of missions here, but no, she's just really cool. She's like, you know what? Here you go. Here's some armor. Okay, so if you guys haven't figured out where we're heading yet, we're going to be heading towards... Tenpenny Towers. Ooh. Why, you might be asking, are we heading to Tenpenny Towers? Well, it's the only place nearby that we can easily obtain more BBs for the BB gun. Captain Gustavo, or whatever the hell his name is. I know he's Gustavo. That's his name. He sells BBs. He's one of the few vendors that actually sells the fucking things. funny enough. The others being one of the ghouls in Underworld. Actually, no, I think he's the only other person that sells them. Just straight up sells them. All right, so while we're on our way towards... okay, we're actually just going to book it. While we're on our way to Tenpenny Towers, I'll talk a little bit about some of the... Oh, shoot, I have to kill these guys. Oh, no, they're stuck. Okay. So, when it comes down to beating this game, we are going to do just about everything that the game will give us, including DLC. Now, the thing about the DLC is that I don't actually know how much of it is beatable without using a real gun. Because I know Operation... I think it's Anchorage, basically takes away all your equipment and gives you a bunch of new stuff and becomes like a shitty little first-person shooter. And that is not okay, because, again, using anything but the BB gun would immediately invalidate the run entirely. You just have to figure out if it's possible to get through without using any weapons other than the BB gun. Mothership Zeta... I'll actually leave that up to you guys in terms of... Because I know for a fact you have to use a weapon to beat it at the very end. I don't know if you guys would qualify that as invalidating the run, but I'll leave that up to the viewer. You guys are going to be really handy in terms of, you know, figuring out how to get all this stuff done. We are going to do Point Lookout and... Maybe the pit. I think you can do the pit as well. I know for a fact you can do Point Lookout without a gun or anything but what you have on you. Okay, now that we've reached the outside of Tenpenny Tower, we're going to quickly, you know, see the very, you know, generic thing that everyone sees when they come here. The ghoul talking to the guy. Gustavo, I think, is actually, funny enough, the guy that we're here to see. I think I can just... Can I just... No, I can't. Okay. I wasn't sure if I could, talk, you know, kind of just cancel them out. I need to actually turn general subtitles on for you guys. I noticed that earlier.
Who the hell are you calling a zombie?
You're definitely not human, that's for damn sure. For the last time, no zombies allowed.
No zombies!
Can't you tell the difference between me and a feral? Fine, I'll show you the goddamn difference. Just you wait. You'll get yours, all of you.
Yeah, so he's kind of hinting at what he plans on doing here, or what he plans on wanting to do here, because, believe it or not, in the basement section of Tenpenny, they're actually pretty close to where these guys, they live in, like, the access tunnel is, like, you can actually get to it from inside Tenpenny Tower. He basically wants to send feral ghouls in to murder everyone, but I'm not gonna do that. Let me in, asshole. Good. No, you're not. No, you're supposed to let me in. Let me in, asshole. Okay. Well, I had to pay up, unfortunately. I'll still be able to afford. Welcome. Fuck you, Gustavo. I'm gonna take my money back from you. I hope you know that.
This better be important.
It is important. You have stuff that I want to buy. You have. Wow. He has 200 BBs on him. That's a lot more than I expected, actually. I'm gonna sell the baseball bat, because I'm gonna basically try and get all my money back from you, because you're a dick. Tinted glasses, tunnel snake outfit I'll hold on to. Man, this stuff is not as, good as I was hoping it would be. I think I can sell, yeah, these are worth a little bit. Okay, except, now I'll buy a now, this is why we came here, he is the easiest place for us to access
a pleasure doing business.
BBs, funny enough. He actually... So Gustavo is going to be really, really handy. And unfortunately, he's... At some point, we're actually going to go help the ghouls. We're going to let them move in here. I actually really would like to have the combat armor that these guys wear. It's surprisingly handy. And I don't think there's anywhere you can actually... obtain it without killing or reverse pickpocketing these guys, which is weird to say the least. I would like your guys' armor, but I don't think there's a way to get it. legitimately, because it gives you a +5 to small guns, and the damage threshold is surprisingly good on those. So we're gonna go back and complete the thing for Moriarty. We're gonna give him his 100 caps, and then I'm gonna end it off there, because next episode we are going to do quite a bit of stuff. We're gonna be working on the Wasteland Survival Guide. We're actually gonna, funny enough, pay a trip to the ghouls, because they have a item that I will that'll really come in handy for a lot of the wasteland, or a lot of the capital wasteland. There's a lot of ghouls, and he has an item that is very, very handy in terms of dealing with ghouls. Moriarty, my man.
A few caps to find out where your father. The wasteland can be such an unforgiving place.
I did you a stupid favor. Now tell me where my father is.
You took care of our little lost lamb, eh? I knew I could count on you. How about you just hand over 100 caps and we'll call it even?
Yeah. Yeah, here you go.
Now that wasn't so difficult, was it? Your dad came through here all right. Didn't stay long, though. Said he had some important business to attend to and headed off to the city. Something to do with Galaxy News Radio. Guess that'd be the place for you to start. Good hunting, and thanks for the caps.
Yeah, no problem. All right, guys. Well, that is it. We are officially done with the first episode of the Fallout 3 BB Gun Only Challenge. So far, not too bad. We got a decent amount of ammo for our gun. We'll definitely be going back to get the other chunk of ammo, since I didn't realize he would actually increase his capacity of ammo after a while. I thought usually he would only hold on to 100 BBs at a time, but he has a lot more than that. So I'll definitely be going off and buying the rest of those when I get the chance. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time for some more Fallout 3. Goodbye.